am your Prasad. This is PPL part 2 video. Principles of Programming Language part 2 video, that is there in JNTUH BTech 3rd year and 4th year CSE. Here we are going to discuss overview of PPL and 5 units introduction and outcome of the subject. After 5th unit, what the student able to do, right? The 5 unit introduction is, first unit preliminary concepts, means basic concepts of PPL. Right, why we have to learn PPL, what are the basic data types, what are olden days languages data types, olden days programming languages introduction and all, syntax and semantics, rules of a programming language, how we should type, semantic without grammatical mistake, how we should type, right, sentence mistake, grammatical mistakes, spelling mistakes, where we should type capital letter, where we should type small letters will be discussed here. And here naming means variable name, right, variable name, how we should take variable names. And binding means wrapping or binding data at one place, right, just like class in Java. Scope means range of a variable or method or a function or anything object in a class or in a function C program that will be bounded that place only, scope of the variable. Data types, how many data types are there, what are the basic things, int, float, char, string, just like that. Expressions and statement, expressions just like some equations, right, ax plus b equal to 0 or else ax square plus bx equal to some z, just like that equations and statements. Every line in the technical programming language are called statement. Every statement end with semicolon is called syntax. In English language we call it as sentences, here we call it as statements. Control structures, how we should control, what is the flow of the control structures and compilers. In third unit we have subprograms and blocks. Subprograms means program within program is called subprograms. Blocks means, in my previous video also I told you, this is the definition of function. Function is a block of code which has some specific functionality, task to do it. For example, printf, it has the function of printing the statements, right, this is a block of code. We have open brackets, square brackets, angular brackets and curly braces. The curly and flower braces indicates the block of code. In that some statement will be there, if you execute that statement synchronously or concurrently, we'll get the output. And implementing subprograms, here we discuss about subprograms, we need to implement those subprograms designing in the new programming language. What are the issues we will raise while designing. Abstract data types, ADT, it is called ADT, hidden data types, right. Okay, next in fourth unit we have object oriented programming. This we can implement in Java or Smalltalk, Ruby or C++ or .NET. We can implement OOPS concepts in this many languages. Object related programming languages, right. Previously we have functional dependent, structure oriented, procedure oriented. Now next generation are object oriented programming language. Concurrency. Concurrency means executing simultaneously or synchronously many threads, many programs. In a big application, big software, we execute all these threads, small programs at a time is called concurrency. Exception and event handling. Exception, the main feature in some programming, new generation programming language is exception. Exception means runtime error. In compile time also we will get some errors, while in runtime also we will get most of the time errors that can be handled through some keywords called try, catch, throw, throws, and finally 5 keywords. Come closer. Try, catch, throw, throws, finally. These are small letters only because these are keywords out of 50 keywords in Java. Whereas in C we have 32 keywords, in Java we have 50 keywords updated. Right, that is called exception. We can handle with this keywords. This is overview of the subject as well as the 5 units. And event, here we have event. Event is a action, is a work, is a task on the application, on the system. What type of event? We have actions with mouse clicks and keyboard typing. We do on every application mouse clicks and keyboard typing. We do this type of event actions that can be handled. Right? For example, take a Gmail. Come closer here. For example, you have in Gmail, you have username and password. And here you have login. Login is a button. Here we will type, right, in Gmail application. In Gmail application, username, you will type some username. And here we have password. And we will click on login, right? Login handling means action or task. Making some action will be handled and some task work will be handled. That works on the monitor or on the system application or mouse clicks. Mouse clicks and keyboard typing. That will be done. I have shown in Gmail. Just like we have some fields, right? Objects, text bar, we'll type some text here. Cursor will be blinking here and we will type some text. And some push buttons will be there in the application. Those are example, OK, cancel and submit. OK and cancel button will push here and submit. And we have radio buttons. For example, gender, male or female. We'll select either one. These are called radio buttons. Or we have check boxes. In check boxes, we have, for example, SSE. Your qualification is 10th. Or inter. Or if you've done BTech. These are called check boxes in a application. Right? And if you are belongs to some area, which country you belongs to, which state you are belongs to, you will have a drop down here, drop down list bar. These are called event handling that can be handled and designed with a programming language background, some calendar in a application. Those will be discussed in the fourth unit, last chapter, third chapter. And fifth unit, we have functional programming language, function oriented, right? For example, printf, scanf, these those things will be there. And logic programming language, logic things will be there. And lastly, we have scripting languages. Functional programming language, some example are Lisp. Lisp. Lisp means show here. Lisp is one of the example of programming language. Here list, L-I-S-T, list, and processing language. L-I-S means list, P means processing language. And we have Erlang. One of the example of functional programming language, Erlang, Haskell, Clojure, these are new, but example, C, C++, ADA, ALGOL also. ALGOL means algorithmic logic, full form, algorithmic logic. These are olden days programming, functional programming language. Logic programming language, one of the example is Prolog, programming logic. And lastly, we have scripting language, front end page designing languages, those are XML. Extensible markup language, PHP, hypertext preprocessor, H will comes first in full form, hypertext preprocessor, ASP, active server pages, this is a family of .NET language, and JSP, Java server pages, this is a family of Java programming language, and Perl, one of the example of scripting languages, HTML, hypertext markup language, JavaScript, and Python, etc. So many are there. These are PPL overview, PPL introduction, and 5 units overview and introduction. And outcome, after 5 units, what the student will be able to? He will come to know what is syntax and semantic of new programming language. And he can be suitably select which software, for which software, which programming language you have to choose. He will come to know to design operating system. What programming language? For Windows, Linux, Macintosh, Apple product, okay? Which language you have to choose for applications like Book My Show, railway ticket booking, flight ticket booking, this type of application, or else any programming language. If you want to design a programming language, again you need a previous programming language. For example, Java is designed in C and C++, right? Any operating system or any application, MS Office, database, for any software package, they required a programming language. They will be capable of choosing appropriate software's language, right? For which software, which application, which language should be taken. And knowledge of future functional programming language, they should have some knowledge. This is a course PPL subject outcome, right? All the best and thank you.